The Chinese government issued its Arab policy paper on January the 13th. Chinese President Xi Jinping is visiting Saudi Arabia, Egypt, and Iran from January the 19th to the 23rd. This is Xi Jinping's first visit to the region since he took office. For Iran, January the 16th was the implementation day of the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. President Xi Jinping will also be the first head of state visiting the country after Iran signed a plan and the UN resolved to end its sanctions on Iran. In this sense, President Xi Jinping's visit is a very important diplomatic move to promote China's relations with the three countries and the region as a whole. Economic and trade cooperation between China and the Arab world is a main content of the Chinese government's Arab policy paper. Arab states as a whole are China's seventh largest trading partner and largest crude oil supplier. Energy cooperation is the core of China-Arab cooperation.
能源的合作确实是中国和阿拉伯国家合作的一个重要的方面，因为这个特点嘛，就是这个地区，它是这个能源富集的地方，所以这也是双方的互补性强的一个很重要的方面。中国，我们的这个对能源进口的需求确实在不断的这个增加，那么我们需要一个稳定的石油供应的来源，那么对于这些产油国这个地区产油国来说，它需要一个稳定的供应市场。
Therefore, Wusaker said, cooperation in the energy field is not only a complementary, but also a win-win solution for both sides, and it has also built a solid foundation for bilateral relations. No matter how the energy structure changes, the Middle East will always make up a very large proportion of China's energy imports. On this basis, cooperation in infrastructure construction and high technology in a new era also continue to grow. China supports a peaceful solution of the conflicts between Israel and Palestine, as well as the security issues between Iran and Saudi Arabia. In fact, China has recently urged Saudi Arabia and Iran to solve their disputes using peaceful means. The paper focuses on security cooperation. China has promised to start security and intelligence cooperation and take part in more joint military drills. However, this part of the paper emphasizes more on anti-terrorism cooperation. The paper also points out that anti-terrorism cooperation should be a long-term project, stressing the importance of annihilating the roots and structures of terrorism.
中国在反恐和推动热点问题解决方面从来没有缺席，没有缺位。我们是要不断地做出努力的。对于军事的这样的一个参与，中国是坚持的一个原则，就是在安理会决议的框架之下，尊重、接受这个维和部队的这样一个存在，这是对于国家主权的一种尊重。只有在这个情况下，中国才会派出军队。